Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. The Dumont Television Network brings you a night at the Cicada Club, broadcast live across the nation and around the world by the miracle of electronic television. Presenting a torrent of top talent and tunes directly into your home from Maxwell DeMille's Cicada Club in Hollywood, California. Tonight, we present Richard Halpern's Roaring Twenties Revue and a special Academy Awards party featuring Miss Mather, the singing coat check girl, vaudeville's brightest stars, Evans and Rogers, and yours truly, Conrad Montebank. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's your master of ceremonies, that howling Hollywood wolf himself, Mr. Maxwell DeMille!
Thank you, Conrad Montebank. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our Academy Awards party. At this moment, the Academy Awards of 1929 are taking place at a gala banquet at the Blossom Room in at the Hollywood Roosevelt Hotel. During tonight's show, we will be relaying to you the names of the winners as they are announced.
Say, Mr. DeMille, I'll bet the folks would like to hear a few interesting facts about tonight's Academy Awards presentation.
I'll say, Conrad.
Well, why don't I read them right from this script?
Certainly.
Tonight's hosts at the Roosevelt Hotel are Academy President Douglas Fairbanks and William C. DeMille.
No relation.
The celebrity-filled Blossom Room is sold out tonight with 250 in attendance at a cost of $10 per person. That's a lot of simoleons. Separate awards for Best Picture will be given for production and unique and artistic picture. Separate awards are also given in directing for comedy and drama. A special award will be given for title writing, a field that may become obsolete with the invention of synchronized sound film 3 years ago in 1926.
Thank you, Conrad Montebank, for those interesting facts.
My pleasure.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to start our party right here at the Cicada Club with Richard Halpern's Roaring Twenties Revue. And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, that Prince of Pip, Mr. Tin Pan Alley himself, the one, the only, Richard Halpern.
Thank you, Mr. DeMille. Hello to all of you here in Hollywood and to you at home, all right? Let's do one of these great songs. This is called Hello, Sunshine, Hello, my new opening theme song. What do you say? I was a lonely one, I'm not the only one, others have been lonely too. Maybe it had to be, gee, but it's bad to be feeling unhappy and blue. But everything's different today, good luck is coming my way. I'm looking up at the sky, I see the clouds rolling by. Hello, sunshine, hello. I'll say you're long overdue, 'cause I've been looking for you. Hello, sunshine, hello. And what if I been gloomy? Listen to me, I'll never be that way again, I know. That certain someone is mine, that's why I want you to shine. Hello, sunshine, hello. Oh, welcome. I know that you're really for me, I know that you're gonna warm me now. Every little ray you sprinkle helps to straighten out my wrinkled brow. Sun rays, your bright rays mean bright days and how. I'm looking up at the sky, I see the clouds rolling by. Hello, sunshine, hello. I say you're long overdue, 'cause I've been looking for you. Hello, sunshine, hello. And what if I've been gloomy? Oh, listen to me. I'll never be that way again, I know. That certain someone is mine. That's why I want you to shine. Hello, sunshine. Hello. Thank you, folks. I hope you enjoyed that little tune from this year, 1929, all right? Now here's a song about the girl that wouldn't say yes, and about her date, and it happened to have been me. I looked in my little red book and found I had a date. At 8:30, I can't be late. Look me over, how do I look? Now tell me, am I there? Tell me on the square, could I make anyone care? I combed my hair, brushed my hat, even washed my dog and cat. Tonight's my night with baby. The onions that I like so much, for weeks I haven't dared to touch. Tonight's my night with baby. Now I call sweetie baby, and here's the reason why. Every time we cuddle, it works just like a lullaby. I hit the parson in the hall, so he'd be there if I should call. Tonight's my night with baby. That's the vamp. All these songs had vamps. I feel just like I'm walking on wheels. I think that I could fly. Look in my eye, and you'll see why. I just had rubber put on my heels. I got no time to lose. Do your duty, shoes. I've run away from the blues. If she says yes, then I'll say yes. If she says no, I'll still say yes. Tonight's my night with baby. And if she says do, I'll say do. If she says don't, I'll still say do. Tonight's my night with baby. We'll move to the North Pole. I know that we're not wrong, 'cause you know at the North Pole the nights up there are 6 months long. I guess she's nice, I hope I'm right, but if I'm wrong, I'll know tonight. Tonight's my night with baby. I got my ma, I got my pa, I put them on my motor car. Hey, tonight's my night with baby. And I said to my driver, Jack, just drive and drive and don't come back, 'cause tonight's my night with baby. Say, we've seen every movie, we've seen every play. We gotta have amusement, but we want it in a different way. I fixed the lights at 10:30, they'll all blow out, oh boy, and then tonight's my night with a baby. Thank you, folks. All right, folks, and now we're going to render a lovely instrumental from the band. What's this one called, Mr. Randy Waltz? This is Glad Ragdoll, one of my very favorite songs. So what do you say, gentlemen? Have you got it? Oh, perfection, okay. Let's do it. And the dance floor is now open, so come on. And don't forget to dance big, all right? Thank you.
and gentlemen, the Blues Serenaders Orchestra. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I've just been informed the very first Academy Award for this season has been given at the Roosevelt Hotel, and that award was for Best Title Writing. I'm sure you're on the edges of your seats as I am. The nominees for Best Title Writing for this year of 1929 are George Marion Jr., not a popular favorite, Gerald C. Duffy, and Joseph Farnham.
Ladies and gentlemen, the art of title writing is a fine art indeed, because every time you watch one of your motion pictures, you watch your dialogue spelled out in an artistic way to the title writing. It's not just plain text they put up there, is it, Conrad?
No, he's choosing fonts and putting those squiggly things at the top and bottom of the screen.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, and the winner for best title writing goes to Joseph Farnham.
Joseph Farnham!
We'll be back with more awards as they are given out there at the Blossom Room in Hollywood, California. But now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for more music, courtesy of the Blue Serenaders Orchestra. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Serenaders Orchestra. And now it's time to bring back to the microphone a man who needs no introduction.
Oh, he got it.
Mr. Richard Halpern, the Prince of Pep.
Who is here from Kentucky? This song is for you, and it's a Jolson song. Like all Kentucky boys, longing for the city's joys, I left the farm and started to roam. Like all Kentucky boys, sick of all the city noise, I heard Kentucky calling me home. Any thrill you get when you are leaving, it doesn't touch the thrill when you return. You're saying hello, Tucky, Tucky, hello. Hello, Tucky, oh, why did I go? What I've been through to get to you, now I found you. Let me put my arms around you, shady bowers, valleys and hills, birdies, flowers, nothing but thrills. I'm glad I went astray to get that kick of saying hello, Tucky, hello. Hello, Tucky, Tucky, hello. Hello, Tucky, oh, why did I go? What I've been through to get to you. Now I found you, let me put my arms around you. Shady bowers, valleys and hills, birdies, flowers, nothing but thrills. I'm glad I went astray to get that kick of saying hello, Tucky, hello. Hello, Tucky, hello. Hope you enjoyed that.
Thank you.
Mr. Stadler, have a And now here's a song from 1927. This is called Me and My Shadow. Al Jolson, Billy Rose, well, it doesn't get much better than that. Shades of night are falling and I'm lonely, standing on the corner, oh so blue. Sweethearts having fun, pass me one by one, guess I'll wind up like I always do, with only me and my shadow. Rolling down the avenue, me and my shadow, not a soul to tell our troubles to. And when it's 12 o'clock, we climb the stair, we never knock, for nobody's there, just me and my shadow, all alone and oh so blue. When the sun sets on the far horizon and the parlor lamps begin to glow, Jim and Jack and John put their slippers on, they're all set, but we're still on the go. So lonely, me and my shadow, strolling down the avenue. Me, me all alone, and my silly old shadow. Not a soul to tell my troubles to. And when I go out at night with my old pal, we never fight about any gal, just me and my shadow, all alone and oh so blue. Thank you, folks. That was Me and My Shadow. So next we have Oh, we have an instrumental from the band. This is a wonderful tune. This is also a Jolson song. This is called Avalon. So the dance floor is open, so what do you say? The Blues Serenaders Orchestra with Avalon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Blues Serenaders. I've just been notified that another award has been given. This, the award for Best Actress in a Leading Role. The nominees, I'm sure you know, are Gloria Swanson for Sadie Thompson, Janet Gaynor for Seventh Heaven.
Conrad, that's singular, Seventh Heaven.
Seventh Heaven.
Thank you.
Seventh Heaven, Well, Janet Gaynor is not singular. She's also nominated for Angel Street.
And Louis, one more.
Yes. Also, Sunrise, A Song of Two Humans. Three for Janet Gaynor. And Louise Dresser for A Ship Comes In.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this year at the Academy Awards, the best actress, it's a body of work, not just one picture that she's in. So she can be judged for several pictures combined, it's the body of the work for the entire year of 1927.
That seems incredibly unfair.
It is indeed, yes. So the period that they judge is from August of 1927 to August of 1928.
So anyone who voted for Seventh Heaven, Angel Street, or Sunrise, or Song of Two Humans would just get piled onto Janet Gaynor's vote pile.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. And I have the winner here. I don't think it's a surprise. The winner of Best Actress, Janet Gaynor.
Janet Gaynor!
For Seventh Heaven, Angel Street, and Sunrise, A Song of Two Humans.
I certainly hope that they change that rule, otherwise Michael Caine will eventually win every year.
Yes, it doesn't really seem fair, does it?
No, it doesn't, Mr. DeMille.
But speaking of two humans,
yes,
I've got two humans that are our special guests this evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, well.
The sensations of vaudeville, not Broadway, but vaudeville, although they have appeared on Broadway. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring them up with a big round of applause. Evans and Rogers.
Evans and Rogers.
So good. Weren't they great, folks?
Yes, thank you.
So, where are you going to appear next?
We are appearing at the Mayflower Club in North Hollywood.
That's March the 27th, and our special guest is none other than
Mr.
Richard
Tin Pan Alley himself.
Richard Halpern.
Oh, you're kidding. I can't wait. I'll be there. March 27th at the Mayflower Club.
Friday night.
That'll be great. All right, folks. Evans and Rogers, and we're going to have some more surprises from them next set. Terrific. Now, that was a great song. Here's another great song. This is a Jolson song that he never recorded, but it's in one of his music books, and he's listed as one of the authors. This is called Hollywood Rose, and it's all about what it was like to get work out here during this period, 1920s. And I hope you enjoy it.
Out in the west, the sun is forever shining. bidding a million roses grow. But mid the sunshine, there is a rose that's pining. One little human rose that I chance to know. Poor little Hollywood rose, so all alone. No one in Hollywood knows how sad she's grown. Her lips keep trying to smile, but all the while they're hiding a heartache that she has known. From way back there she came in search of wealth and fame, but it's a losing game that she must play. And now wherever she goes, they laugh at Hollywood Rose and tell poor Hollywood Rose nothing for you today. They call her Hollywood Rose, she's all alone. No one in Hollywood knows just how sad she's grown. Her lips keep trying to smile, but all the while they're hiding all the heartache that she has known. From way back there she came in search of wealth and fame, but it's a losing game that she must play. And now wherever she goes, they laugh at a Hollywood Rose and tell poor Hollywood Rose nothing for you today.
Hollywood Rose. How do you do, Mr. DeMille? I hope you enjoyed that song.
I'm doing swell, Mr. Halpern.
Did you like that song? You didn't answer me.
Yes, well, isn't Richard Halpern our own original Hollywood Rose?
See, nobody laughed at that. See, that's what you get.
That's because it's
and
true.
And you got feedback, too.
Yes, it's true, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Tin Pan Alley, Richard Halpern will be back right after this next number.
I sure will. Oh, is... who I think coming up.
We've had many, many requests, ladies and gentlemen, for this next guest star.
Yowza, yowza, yowza.
And she'll be up very shortly. I know lots of you folks watching our broadcast that is being transmitted around the world.
Yes.
I've been requesting this next young lady who will be coming up in just a few moments. We'd like to say hello to everyone watching the broadcast. Right up
yes,
there is our
hello
special
everybody.
Cameras.
And you know what, Maxwell? It's birthdays tonight. You know that?
We do. Who's having a birthday tonight?
My sister Jane is having her 21st birthday. There she is.
Well, we'll do a special birthday number in just a few moments, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, let's turn it over to the Blue Serenaders Orchestra.
What song is this, Mr. Randy Waltz? You do? Well, then you better sit down.
He's got a feeling he's falling, ladies and gentlemen. A little too much of that bootleg gin, I'll say.
I made him do it.
And say, folks, if you're getting a bit thirsty, why not visit our bar up in the mezzanine lounge? They have wonderful drinks they'll serve you in teacups, and we won't say what it is, will we?
I know what it is. They have absinthe.
Yes.
They have absinthe up there.
Absinthe?
Absinthe to get you in a taxi, honey.
Absinthe.
Thank you. See, they laughed at my joke.
Hey, Mr. Halpern, let's get off. Let's quit while we're ahead. Let's quit while we're ahead, shall we?
Yes, let's go. Okay. I got a feeling I'm falling. Blue Serenade. Wait.
Okay. He's got the verse. Thank you.
The Blues Serenader Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, the Blues Serenaders. I've just been handed word that the next award has been given there at the Roosevelt Hotel. The nominees for Best Actor in a Leading Role are Emil Jennings for The Last Command, Richard Barthelmess for The Noose,
and The Patent Leather Kid.
Emil Jennings for The Way of All Flesh, and Richard Barthelmess for The Patent Leather Kid.
In other words, ladies and gentlemen, Emil Jennings for two films and Richard Barthelmess for two films. And now, the winner for Best Actor, 1929, ladies and gentlemen, Emil Jennings.
Emil Jennings.
Congratulations, sir. I know you're enjoying your banquet at the Hollywood Roosevelt Hotel there in the Blossom Room on Hollywood Boulevard.
Indeed.
And now it's time to bring to the stage a very special guest performer.
Is it Emil Jennings?
Yes, it's not Emil Jennings.
No.
Someone even better than the best actor. Ladies and gentlemen, you know her as our delightful coat check girl. No. Here she is, the one, the only, Miss Mather. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Mather. Say, Miss Mather, don't go away. This microphone is on an international hookup across the nation and around the world. Is there anything you'd like to say to your fans that may be watching and listening in?
Hi, Mom.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Mather.
Yes.
Thank you. Now, back to your coat check station. And ladies and gentlemen, be sure to tip Miss Mather generously. That's the only way she makes a living. Tonight. And now, here he is once again, the Prince of Pep, Mr. Tin Pan Alley, the Titan of Tinseltown, Richard Halpern.
Thank you, Mr. DeMille. This is yet a... Hello, yes. Why don't you come over, come closer, dear, so we can get a look at you around the world. Give him a drum beat, come on. Yes, what's your name, dear? Katrina! You caused a sensation in Louisiana. Let's give her a hand. Lovely Katrina, spending her Oscar night with us tonight. Thank you, dear. And you sure know how to cut a rug out there. Yes, take care. All right. Wow. It reminds me that my tire is rotated. Thank you, dear. This is a song called Lost, a Wonderful Girl. All right? So this... Mr. Newspaper Man, please help me out if you can. My sweetie wandered away. I fear she may go astray. I've searched for her every place, but I haven't found any trace. I'm feeling awfully bad, so please run this ad in your lost and found column today. I've lost a wonderful girl. Wonderful girl, please help me find her and remind her she is all the world to me. Without her, I don't even care about living. Tell her everything will be forgiven. I would give up all that I own. Lost without her, lost a wonderful girl. Won't the finder please return her to me? That's another vamp. I have been waiting in vain, hoping to hear once again her sweet voice calling to me. I wonder where she can be. Feelings I can't disguise, and everyone reads in my eyes. They see that I'm all upset. Seems I just can't forget. There's but one thing to do: advertise. I've lost a wonderful girl, a beautiful pearl. Her name is Sally from Tin Pan Alley. Grace. Years ahead of Valentino. When she rolls her eyes at the men, they fall and never get up again. She's just a home destroyer, lost a wonderful girl. Oh, won't the finder please return her to me? Thank you, folks. Miss Lola, darling, come on up here. Let's give her a little drum beat. Come on. Yes, dear, come on up, darling. Lola. Her name was Lola. She was a cigarette girl. So, having any luck tonight with cigarettes?
Not much, darling.
Not much. Well, we got to do something about that. They're all bubblegum cigarettes so that we can adhere to the code of the noble experiment, which is prohibited, you know, substances like that. So, but go ahead. This is all for you. It's all good enough, safe for the kiddies. All right? So give her a big hand, Miss Lola. Thank you, darling. Wow. What is this now? Now we have a... I know, Randy. I know you. Oh, that's the title of the song. Okay, the name of the song is I Can't Give You Anything But Love. And maybe I'll sing this one. What key is it in? What do we care? It's the key of Yale. The key of Yale, right? Who got that joke? The key of Yale. Thank you, Laura Brodian. You're a scholar. You know, all right. Okay, this is I Can't Give You Anything But Love, Baby. Thank you.
baby. That's the only thing I've plenty of, oh baby. Dream a while, scheme a while, we're sure to find happiness. And I guess all those things you've always pined for. Gee, I'd like to see you looking swell, baby. Diamond bracelets for worth doesn't sell. Oh, baby, till that lucky day, you know darn well, baby, I can't give you anything but love.
Serenaders Orchestra. Now, here's a song from 1925 that's as timely today as it was then. So maybe you've seen people like this wandering the streets, or maybe in this club, you don't know. But it's an enigma. That's a big word. Look it up, and if you like it, you'll forgive me. What do you say, sir? This man, I'll say, go anywhere, just stand and stare. You'll say they're bugs when you look at the clothes they wear. Masculine women, feminine men, which is the rooster, which is the hen? It's hard to tell them apart today and say, now sister is busy learning to shave, brother just loves his permanent wave. It's hard to tell them apart today, hey, hey. boys were boys when I was a tot. Now we don't know who is who or even what's what. Knickers and trousers, baggy and wide. Nobody knows what's lurking inside those masculine women and feminine men. Stop, look, listen, and you'll agree with me. Things are not what they used to be, you'll see. You say hello to Uncle Joe, then look again, and you'll find it's your Auntie Flo. Masculine women, feminine men, which is the rooster, which is the hen? It's hard to tell them apart today and say, now Auntie is smoking, rolling her own. Uncle is always buying cologne. It's hard to tell them apart today. Hey, hey. Give your girl a kiss in the hall, but instead you find you're kissing her brother Paul. Ma's got a sweater up to her chin, Pa's got a girdle holding him in. Those masculine women and feminine men. It's hard to tell them apart today. Now wifey is playing billiards and pool, hubby is dressing the kiddies for school. It's hard to tell them apart today, hey, hey. Since the Prince of Wales in ladies' dresses was seen, what does he intend to be, the king or the queen? Grandmother buys those tailor-made clothes, grandfather tries to smell like a rose. Those masculine women and feminine men. Well, folks, come on up, Maxwell. I think we're going to take a little break now. Let you do it.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear for Richard Halpern, the Prince of Pants. Now, Richard and the Blues Serenaders Orchestra will take a short break, and then we'll be back with another full set of Richard Halpern's Roaring Twenties Revue. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to let you know next week here at the Cicada Club will be Jennifer Keith and the High Society Boys, where we bring you back to the 1940s. The band will also be featuring members of the Royal Crown Revue Big Band, so you won't want to miss that evening, and it's going to be swell fun for everybody. And again, we will be broadcasting that show for you here next week from the Cicada Club. But now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to turn the dance floor over to you with some recorded music.